Human population in the Chesapeake Bay region increased by 8% from 1990 to 2000. During the same period, development increased by 25%, significantly reducing the amount of forest and farmlands. For example, about 100 acres of forest is consumed by development every day. Due to new development, hard surfaces such as pavement, driveways, and rooftops increased by 41%. In new development, only 15% of rainfall is absorbed by soils, and 55% runs off. In contrast, in forest lands, 50% of rain is absorbed by soils, and only 5% runs off into streams. Multiple studies have demonstrated that stream health declines dramatically as the total hard surface and watershed exceeds 10%. We are beginning to see fewer streams that look clean like this one. In urban areas, pollutants such as sediment, trash, oils, fertilizers, and toxic chemicals contaminate the watershed. So, how can we live in urban environments and reduce our impacts on streams and rivers? Low impact development, or LID, reduces polluted runoff by mimicking the natural filtration that occurs in forest ecosystems. The Science Museum of Virginia was awarded a grant from the National Fish and Wildlife Foundation to create a stormwater demonstration, education, and training facility. This program encourages behaviors that reduce stormwater and pollutants entering the James River and Chesapeake Bay. Installation of various LID stormwater techniques began with the Bayscapes Garden, composed of native vegetation planted by museum volunteers. More advanced practices, such as bioretention, were constructed using engineered soils to capture and remove pollutants. Each practice is scientifically monitored to quantify performance. Tree box filters were installed to act as smaller bioretention facilities. Pervious concrete allows rainwater to percolate into the ground, which filters and slows the release of stormwater. A vegetated roof was installed to minimize the amount of hard surfaces and to reduce heating and cooling costs. One train shed is equipped with a 2,500-gallon cistern to capture and store rainwater for irrigating our urban farm. The museum also created Rainkeepers, an engaging, interactive exhibit with over 25 experiences. Key topics include average to extreme rains and flooding, cross-sections and photos of each of the LID stormwater practices, citizen science voting stations covering 11 stormwater issues, and river and ocean pollution. And of course, we could not have done this alone. Collaboration and synergy among our project partners and local and national businesses played an important role in the success of this project. As a result, the museum has become Central Virginia's go-to place for stormwater demonstration, education and training, and is a catalyst for changing behaviors that benefit us all. And now you've watched an entire video about stormwater. How draining.